Hey everybody, Mr. Grove here. Today we are going to talk about some poisonous and edible mushrooms. And so there are six that I would like you to know of each. And these are all semi-common in our area, but definitely ones that you would want to know. And there are definitely lots more poisonous and edible than just this list of six on each. But these are just the ones that are a little bit more common that you might run into. So we'll start with the poisonous ones first. Definitely the worst is going to be this guy, the Amanitis. And so the Amanitis, there's several different varieties of these. They're kind of called the Death Angel or some sort of variation of that. But one of the things you kind of want to look for is when you see this little skirt. That's usually a bad sign. None of our six common edibles are going to have that. So again, with poisonous mushrooms, you just want to, if you're not sure, you definitely want to make sure that you don't take any chances. But if you are sure and you want to try some mushrooms, go for it. So another one is going to be the emetic russula. And so this russula is going to look something like this. And this is kind of your classic Mario Brothers kind of mushroom. So this bright reddish, kind of reddish orange cap with a nice thick white stem. And so that one, again, is poisonous. So the Amanitis, some very serious poison, potentially deadly. This guy is going to be pretty poisonous. You definitely don't want to mess with it, but maybe not technically as deadly per se. But definitely nothing to be messing with. Another one that is on our list is going to be the false morel. Okay, so our false morel. And this is going to be compared to the morel, which is not only not poisonous, but very delicious. So the biggest thing on the false morel is number one, they really don't look all that much alike. This one's really wrinkly. The morel is going to be kind of pitted as such. You can't really go by the color as much because there are morels that are black and gray. But that rusty orange is kind of unique to the false morel. And again, it's more wrinkly rather than pitted like the morel. But the telltale sign, though, when it's all said and done, morels are hollow in the stem, and you're going to probably cut it anyway if you're going to think about eating it. And so that hollow stem means you're okay. False morels are going to be solid all the way through the stem. So false morel, stay away from those. The next one is the jack-o'-lantern. Okay, and so you can see why it's called the jack-o'-lantern with this nice bright orange color. And so the easiest way to tell the jack-o'-lantern from the edible, and the edible version of this orange mushroom is called the chanterelle. And these are of the two, the edible versus the poisonous, these are probably the two that look the most alike. But there is a pretty easy way you can tell them apart. So the jack-o'-lantern, the stem, when you go to cut it, you're going to see on the stem that it's orange all the way through, whereas the chanterelle is going to be white in the middle of the stem. Still be solid, it'll just be white. Okay, so that is going to be the jack-o'-lantern. It's orange, you can kind of think of orange being danger. Another of our mushrooms that are poisonous are these guys. They are called the little brown mushrooms, the LBMs. And these definitely have they can be pretty serious and potentially fatal. Our jack-o'-lantern and our false morel probably more make you sick kind of poison, but the LBMs can be pretty serious. So, and again, there's really nothing that grows around here that we would even come close to looking like this that would be edible. So LBMs, stay away from those. And then our last one, this one's kind of interesting because it's more of a yard mushroom, okay? And this is called the green-spored Lepoidea. And so you can't really see the spores very good on this one, but a couple of things. First of all, the stalk. So again, that's usually a sign to stay away. The other is that we would have, if you looked at this closely, there would be green specks in the gills, and that would be the green spores. But this one typically grows in like a lawn environment, so it's very common for you to see this in kind of the summer lawn. It will also kind of grow in this little, what's called a fairy ring, so this kind of circle maybe 10, 12, 20 foot in diameter, in the lawn. And so remember, the mycelium is that giant, you know, massive hyphae underneath. And so what's just popping through then would be the fruiting structure, and that would be the green spore of the poidea. So those were our six poisonous ones. And now let's switch over to our six edibles. So first is the morels. So like we said, they could be black, yellow, gray. And these are a spring mushroom. They're oftentimes associated with mycorrhizae of certain types of trees. So maybe elm or apple types of trees, ash perhaps. And so the different, very pitted, very not as wrinkly, but more pitted. And that stem is going to be completely hollow. Okay, so those are excellent to eat. And if you don't like eating them, find them and sell them. You can usually get about $50 a pound. Another edible, which is edible doesn't always mean good. And it's kind of hard to imagine it's edible, but it's an unbelievable mushroom. And that's the wood ear. And so it literally looks like this little jelly ear that grows on like a log or something. And so that is the wood ear. It is edible. It is not necessarily what I would call good, though. So that's the wood ear. Another edible one is the puffball. And so you see these in your yard. You do kind of have to be a little bit careful because that puffball could look like a green spore lepoidea that's just not opened up yet. So the recommendation there is if you're like, well, I think that's a puffball, just let it go a couple of days. It's either going to open up if it's a lepoidea, or if it's a puffball, it's going to stay as a big puffy ball. And it'll just be a little bit bigger, so there's more of it to eat. Again, edible doesn't mean necessarily good. So eat at your own culinary caution. But that's the puffball, another edible one. The chanterelle, like we said, we find these kind of in a little bit of a wooded area, like a wooded yard is where we found a lot of them. And so they're orange, but if you notice, the stem is white. So you're going to cut it anyway if you're thinking about eating it. The other thing is the gills are forked. So as the gill comes up here, it forks off. Gill comes up, it forks off. The jack-o'-lantern, those gills just go straight all the way through. But that stem's pretty much this giveaway. So orange is warning. So the jack-o'-lantern is orange. Chanterelle is not. And then this one is interesting because it's a fall mushroom. And this is called hen of the woods. And so these get these little shelfy fungus-like things. And it looks kind of like a big feathers of like a chicken that are kind of ruffled up. They can get up to like a volleyball, maybe even a girl's basketball size. And so this is hen of the woods, and they're usually associated with oak trees. So at the base of an oak tree, and definitely not only edible, but, and not too bad either. Maybe not a morel quality, but you know, close, and you can have it in the fall, and there's usually a lot of it when you find it. So that is hen of the woods, another edible. And then lastly, an edible is the oyster mushroom. And so they're usually kind of this off-white. This one's a little bit more brown than usual, but kind of that off-white, not a pure snow white, grow on the side of trees or on the side of a dead log or something like that. But that is the oyster mushroom. And that one's not too bad. And that's easy to grow sometimes in your own kind of homegrown kits. You can get some oyster mushroom spawn and grow those as well. So those are the six edibles. So our wood ear, puffball, chanterelle, oyster, hen of the woods, and the morels. But if you're not sure, make sure, you know, if you have any doubts at all, just don't eat it. But if you're sure and you want to give it a try, go for any of these six edibles. So I hope that was helpful, and we'll catch you later.